Ventricular tachycardia management. Whilst a broad complex tachycardia may result from a supraventricular rhythm with aberrant conduction, the European Resuscitation Council advised that in a peri-arrest situation, it is assumed to be a ventricular in origin. Ventricular tachycardia is broad complex tachycardia originating from a ventricular ectopic focus. It has the potential to precipitate ventricular fibrillation and hence requires urgent treatment. There are two main types of ventricular tachycardia. Monomorphic ventricular tachycardia, most commonly caused by myocardial infarction. Polymorphic ventricular tachycardia, a subtype of polymorphic ventricular tachycardia is dorsatsti pointis, which is precipitated by prolongation of the QT interval. Management. If the patient has adverse signs, systolic BP is less than 90, chest pain, heart failure, or heart rate greater than 50 beats per minute, then immediate cardioversion is indicated. In the absence of such signs, antiarrhythmics may be used. If these fail, then electrical cardioversion may be needed with synchronized DC shocks. Ventricular tachycardia with pulse not responding to medical treatment, then the treatment is synchronized cardioversion. Pulseless ventricular tachycardia or ventricular fibrillation, treatment is asynchronized DC cardioversion. Drug therapy. Number 1, amiodarone, ideally administered through a central line, 300 mg over the first hour, then 900 over next 23 hours. Number 2, lidocaine, used with caution in severe left ventricular impairment as it is negative inotropic drug. Number 3, procainamide. Verapamil should not be used in ventricular tachycardia. If drug therapy fails, electrophysiological studies, EPS, implantable cardioverter defibrillator, it is particularly indicated in patients with significantly impaired left ventricular function. Important points: hypokalemia is the most important cause of ventricular tachycardia clinically, followed by hypomagnesemia. Severe hyperkalemia may cause ventricular tachycardia in certain circumstances, for example in patients with structural heart disease, but it is not as common as cause as hypomagnesemia. The 2010 ALS guidelines state that if a patient has monitored and witnessed ventricular fibrillation or pulseless ventricular tachycardia in a hospital, 3 quick successive stacked shocks, 200 joules, should be given. Chest compressions should be started immediately after the third, with the compression to ventilation ratio 30:2 for 2 minutes.